I'm Heather King. Welcome to my story, Running with No Filter. Come on in. Running with No Filter, a 6-year journey. My story is filled with broken pieces, terrible choices, and very ugly truths. But it's also filled with a major comeback, peace in my soul, and a grace that saved my life. I was born a runner, according to my parents. I ran everywhere as a child. I wasn't much of a sprinter, but definitely enjoyed cross country in high school and in college, and I ran simply to stay in shape. Footprints in the cement. In 2012, I fell in love with Black Girls Run Atlanta. I had a kid in college and my stress was high. I knew how to be a parent, but no one taught me how to let go once she became an adult. I started attending weekly group runs and met some amazing women that inspired me and motivated me and simply focused on me. I would be lying if I sat here and said it was easy, but I stuck with it and began to sign up for local races. And in 2013, I asked a few of my running buddies to run a marathon with me. And without much hesitation, they said, let's do it. Marine Corps Marathon was my very first marathon. After reading Tony Reed's book on running 7 marathons on 7 continents, I was intrigued. And deep down, I really wanted to do exactly what he had done, especially since no one in my family ran, nor did they have a passport. Ha ha, I thought, I'll be the first one in my family. Little known Black history. I sat down and put my 7-year plan together. I would run a marathon on each continent each year and would be finished before I turned 50. And what a great 50th birthday present that would be for myself. I already had North America, and in 2014, I had the privilege of running Paris Marathon. Next up, 2015, I was headed to Beijing, China. Beijing, China. Who runs a marathon in Beijing, China on the Great Wall? All I knew was I ain't going by myself. So as normal, I'd ask a few people, anybody want to join me? I'll post it on social media and see who responds. Kimberly Crenshaw and Carrie Fox answered that call, and the planning stages began. How do you run 26.2 miles on the Great Wall of China? Add in 5,124 steps into the mix and you get the Great Wall of China. There were no training plans out there, so we created one and started a stair challenge that spread it all over the running community. We have folks posting how many stairs they climbed on a daily basis. You see, we needed all the support we could get. Anthony Malone, a marathoner in the ATL, had just started his own magazine called Atlanta Sports Magazine and wanted to write a story on 3 Black women who set out to run the Great Wall of China. He referred to us as the Beijing Queen and the Butterfly Ninjas. Atlanta local running stores, Fidipity, stepped up and provided gear from head to toe. I threw a Great Wall of China day party and the city came out and sent us off in a big way. We arrived in Beijing and I was looking for runners that looked like me, and well, there weren't too many. The day before the race, you go to the Great Wall of China and you simply observe, take pictures, but in all hindsight, you're actually climbing the first 3 miles of the course, which was all uphill. I was excited but frightened at the same time. The stairs in the tourist videos didn't look the same. Some of the stairs were missing and you had to jump to get to the next one. They also failed to show the drop-off next to the railing. Lord, what did I get myself into? The air quality was horrible. My sinuses were acting up and my nerves were shot. We arrived at the wall at 3 a.m. on race day and started when the sun rose. I was ready to do what I came to do, but what little did I know that day was I was already behind the eight ball. The heat was not in my favor. It was the hottest day in marathon history. Folks were dropping off like flies, and I never considered dropping down to the half marathon. You see, I am Heather King. And that just wasn't an option. The running community had our backs, and we had to bring that gold back to the ATL. The 5,124 steps along with the elevation had thrown in some heat from the equator, broke me all the way down. At mile 16, I saw what I thought was a horse tied to a tree. I was tripping. I know I didn't see no horse tied to no tree, but maybe I did. I'm no quitter by no means, but I knew my body had taken me as far as I could go, and broke all the way down. I promise y'all, I cried till I threw up. And I just simply was angry at myself because I knew I wasn't going to make that cutoff in time to get to the second set of stairs. You see, there was still 5,120 more steps to go. I would get a medal, but not a marathon finishing time. Therefore, it's not going to count. I came all this way and failed. The first time I failed at anything in years. My first did not finish, DNF. I went all the way to Beijing and failed. I let myself down, and I felt like I let my running community down. I beat myself up for a while. It definitely humbled me, but it taught me that I was human and failure was a part of life, and it's how you get back up that counts. Outside the lane, I was somebody's grandmother. Girl, my first thought was, I am too young to be somebody's grandmother. And I was so close to getting my life back. My youngest daughter, Jade, was almost out of high school. Well, child, I went to go run a race in Madison to Chicago, the Ragnar race. 12 girls in 2 vans. And Zoe Chanel was born June the 6th, 2014. So while I'm out at zone 3, I became a grandmother. And I know what you're thinking. Way to go, Grandma. You sure starting off to a good start. I felt horrible, don't get me wrong. But there was nothing I could do. So we came a week early, and I thought I could go run this race, come back, and be there just in time. And, well, that was not the plan. So I arrived back in Atlanta just in time to pick my daughter Diamond and Zoe up from the hospital and took them home. My life took a detour. I began to look for a marathon in Asia and was able to secure a bid for Tokyo. I needed to stay on course to reach the goal. Wasn't sure I could return to the Great Wall of China, at least not right now. It was too expensive, the conditions, the memories. Tokyo had a course limit that was strictly enforced and checkpoints. And again, I questioned if I could do it. And of course I could. I'm Heather King. Kim Crenshaw answered the call, along with Felicia McLean, and off we went to Tokyo. You see, I try not to travel alone unless I have to. A concrete testimony. March 2016, Team Takedown Publix was born. Team Takedown Publix consisted of one person having a vision and asking other people to join in the vision. I asked one person on March the 16th of 2016, who wanted to run Georgia Publix Marathon with me. Within 24 hours, we had 100 people signed up. Somebody told somebody and somebody told somebody else. Before you know it, we had set our eyes on selling out the Publix Marathon. I wanted to have the most number of African Americans to run one single marathon. You always see people ask, what if we all ran, what would it look like? I wanted to see that vision, and I was willing to do anything, sacrifice anything and anybody to make that vision happen. We traveled around the country, we cheered for races, we spread the word. Team Takedown Publix is broke. We have no money. We are not an LLC. It was simply one person that wanted this dream to come true, and other people joined in. By March the 16th of 2017, we had over 500 African Americans lined up to run one marathon. Where'd they do that at? Team Takedown Publix saved my life. And that's what literally happened. It saved my life. They say if it don't kill you, it'll make you stronger. But damn, who wanted to be that strong? In 2017, I lost my mother to cancer and my husband to his secret family and newborn son. You see, it became difficult to walk a mile in my shoes. In 2017, I bounced back. I put a call out to the running community again. Who want to party with Heather King in Berlin? Because ain't no party like a Heather King party, because a Heather King party don't stop. I was prepared for the response. It was overwhelming. Berlin was a party on the pavement. I was so proud I called our group hashtag Berlin Blackish, and we were rolling 52 deep. Can you imagine 52 African Americans in Berlin, Germany to run one marathon? Baby, we did that. After Berlin, I was mentally and physically exhausted. I had more than 2 deaths in 1 year, and depression set in. Life was real. I sought out counseling, and my true friends checked in on me and truly helped me weather that storm. I switched gears and tabled the seven continents, and set out to finish the world major marathons. I deserve some good luck in my life. I deserve some kind of happy ending after all that I had gone through. I already had Chicago, New York, Tokyo, and Berlin. All I needed was Boston and London. Yep, that's all. Just those two. Baby, I got focused in true Heather King fashion and set my eyes on Boston and London. Two marathons in 1 week in two different countries. I could do it, right? Because, again, I was Heather King. I had nothing to lose, but I had everything to gain. Boston, hands down, was going to be a charity. And I raised $7,500 in 47 days for Fearless 261. Boston broke me all the way down to my core. Again, why do you have to be that strong? I asked God if he was mad at me. He threw the worst possible weather imaginable in Boston race history. You see, the elites were dropping out, but not Heather King. Quitting was not an option, and folks paid $7,500 for this bid. Child, I couldn't let them folks down. They done gave me their money. I owed them dearly. I arrived in London 3 days later after Boston, sore, limping. I had deep chafing cuts that wrapped around my body. I was dehydrated. You name it, I had it. I started to believe somebody needed to be Heather King because, honey, I was tired as hell and I just wanted to sleep. Oh, but I did this to myself. Nobody made me do this. I signed up for this foolery and I had to push through because, again, I believed in myself. London Marathon had the hottest race in marathon history. Not to mention they ran out of water and folks was dropping out like flies from dehydration. At mile 21, my feet blistered. I could barely walk. I had no more laughs in me. My body shut down and I felt as though I was a walking zombie. Just like in the movies, I just followed the crowd. I saw my friend Roosevelt Giles on the course and baby, I took off limping and yelling his name. I swear God sent him to me to help me get to that finish line. You see, I had met Roosevelt in Beijing at the Great Wall of China. He was asking folks, do you know Heather King? I had never met him, but at some point he had heard of me. We met and we've been friends ever since. Roosevelt has been on the same journey with me. Matter of fact, Roosevelt is on his second six-star world marathons. Roosevelt got me to that finish line and we cried and laughed. Well, I did all the crying, he did all the laughing. But when they put that six-star finisher's medal around my neck, I couldn't wait to bring that baby back to the ATL. I was gonna have me a parade on Peter Street with my medal. Look, y'all, this journey has been long but rewarding. It has taught me many life lessons. I'm truly grateful for my family, especially my girls. I hope they understand that I just was not gone running all those days, but I was simply trying to save my own life and shield them from the pain that I was carrying. When life knocks you down, as long as you get back up and keep it moving, all things are possible. I'm honored to be surrounded by so many disciplined people that are friends who have become family that I was able to actually pick for myself. I have told them personally, thank you. My running family near and far is so dope and loyal. Trust and believe, I can go to any city and get a run in and throw a day party. The ATL running community forever and ever. Let's keep raising the bar. The world is watching. My Peter Street family spin 255 off the hook. Habanas, thank you for your loyalty. From day one, you simply asked, what can we do to help you? And you're still here helping me. Thank you guys for coming out. I appreciate you, and I hope at some point I have inspired you to dream big.